As someone who's always enjoyed hiking and the occasional camping trip, I'd become curious about what it would be like to do an intense multi-day trek during my travels. While visiting Cusco, Peru, I decided to sign up for a 5-day, 5-night Salkantay trek to Machu Picchu. The Salkantay trek is an alternative to the traditional Inca Trail that's known for being a bit tougher physically, more remote, and less crowded. It's also cheaper and can be booked at the last minute, which fits my travel style perfectly. In this vlog series, I'll be taking you along on what can easily be called one of the greatest adventures of my travels to date. You'll trek with me, eat with me, get soaked in the rain with me, and see what it's like to set sight on Machu Picchu for the first time. I hope you brought a good pair of hiking shoes with you. Good morning, it's day two. I think I look a little crazy this morning, but yeah, it was cold last night. We slept in the tents, but I will say that like the Alpaca Expeditions team did everything they could to try to like help us keep warm at night. We had like hot water bottles in our sleeping bag and an extra thick wool blanket over the top of us, so that was really nice. I still don't know if I slept that much, like maybe a little bit more than the first night. But I feel like both nights so far, when I wake up, like after the initial like sleeping, I wake up and I just like never go back to bed. I think it's because I drink too much for dinner and I have to pee, but it's cold and I'm not going outside to go pee in the dark. So I just lay there and yeah, but it's okay. Yeah, whew, definitely tired, definitely a little sick, but it's gonna be a good day. I can't get over this view though, like literally we're camping below this incredible glacier. And there's horses right here. More glaciers up to the left. Good morning, Mary. I know, right? Like, how is this real life, you know? I need to introduce everyone, actually, I haven't done that. Okay, I'll do that now. Okay, we have Mary.
Hi!
Say something interesting, Mary!
Say something. Hola.
Hola.
Oh yeah, she speaks Spanish.
Oh, tengo mucho frío ahora porque es muy temprano en la mañana y dormimos abajo de esta grande montaña aquí. Muy bonita, muy hermosa. Y este es mi compañero.
Eugenio.
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 Sí, estoy buscando un Starbucks, pero no hay. Pero no, no importa.
Estoy buscando.
El desayuno era muy rico. Estoy muy feliz por eso.
Sí.
Okay.
Follow that.
Pressure's on, guys.
Follow that, I'm following.
Yeah.
I'm Los dos ángeles.
Y estoy Roberto. Y, Es la luna de miel. Y,
and it's been lots of fun. We're lucky. And we're tired.
All good.
Okay. In the guide.
Hola, hola. Welcome to Peru. Bienvenidos a Peru, chicos. Hace mucho frío, pero vamos a calentar caminando, ¿ya?
Yeah.
Corriendo, corriendo.
Butterflies?
I guess we're going to become in a day moth.
That's where we're going.
You can see the trail going up. It's like a line in the middle of the bushes going up. Can you see just in front of us? Just there?
Like the first ridge?
The first ridge. The lower ridge here. Yeah, you can see. Yeah, the mountain is coming lower and up is coming up one more time. Yeah, the lower part is our ridge that we have to ride.
Is there a bridge down there?
Yeah, it's down there on the river.
Okay. Day two began with a 2-hour descent from our camp into the valley below. We left behind the cold glacial landscape and traded it for a warm, lush jungle. The scenery wasn't quite as beautiful or as dramatic as the first day, but we were happy to shed some layers and know we were getting closer to Machu Picchu. Thank God I rented hiking shoes. Yeah, let's see yours. This is how you do it. Not this.
You would have definitely lost them to do this.
I was literally thinking about that.
You
like,
would have gone forever.
Thank you. morning we started with about like a 2 hour descent, I think he said, and then now we're doing an ascent for 2 hours and then down again for a couple hours before lunch. So this little section of the trail right here is pretty muddy, and that's because it's not like a commonly used trail. I guess like the one that is the normal trail got kind of wiped out by a landslide, so this is the alternative to walking on the road for 4 hours. So we chose the adventure and we are getting one. I don't know if you can tell, it's just like mud everywhere.
Not more surprised by that. Vamos, chicos, vamos. Vamos, vamos! Let's go, guys! Super hikers!
Yeah. Oh. I think she has a plan.
I think she has a plan designed. Mm-hmm. Nice.
There's no act natural with you guys, is there?
Are we supposed to act natural? You can get the director.
Sorry,
from the director.
Uh-huh. Go ahead. Let's redo it. Yeah, let's redo it. What are we going to say? What do you want us to say?
All right, you want us to say, act natural?
I say ow, and you say paca.
Paca.
Ow.
Paca.
Ow.
Paca.
Ow.
Paca.
Ow.
Paca.
Por arriba.
Wait.
These are the two troublemakers of the group behind me.
Okay.
Just came down off the hill. I was like, way more of a grueling descent than yesterday, actually. I mean, yesterday was a tougher hike, but holy crap, my knees hurt so bad. We're on like a road now type of thing, and lunch is literally just right in front of me, so almost there. And then after lunch we have about 2 hours, I believe, more, and they're hoping to get us to our camp tonight a bit early because there's a jacuzzi. Although it's so hot right now, a jacuzzi doesn't sound nice, but I'm sure tonight, once I like cool down and relax, it will. Oh, my knees feel broken. Oh, hola. Buenos dias. Oh my God. This looks a little sus up here. Not, you know, a little landslidey.
Did you say sus, like suspect?
Yes.
Oh, Gen Z.
Oh, no, I was just gonna say.
I'm not, I'm 25, guys.
Are you not Gen Z? No,
okay, technically, I think it's 96. I'm 96, but I count myself as millennial.
So
sure.
You identify as
millennial, okay. Yes. I identify as millennial, okay. Yep.
I find that a little sus, but we'll talk about it later.
Wait, are you a millennial?
I'm an elder millennial.
Because I'm a millennial.
You're a millennial.
You're a boomer.
I am not a boomer.
Are you a boomer?
I might be late boomer, but...
No, you're not.
I was...
No, my dad is...
No, you're Gen Xer, probably.
Or sorry, yeah.
Yeah, you're X. I was gonna say, my parents are boomers, so...
That's right, I'm not a boomer.
But...
It's like layers and layers.
Like
layers and layers. So we call this the silver of dawns, usually, because when it's wet with water, it's gonna be so shiny.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? But it's not silver, so, you know, it's mica stones.
Yeah?
Yeah. Cool silver. Ha 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 ha!
This last stretch for today is 2 hours just on like this dirt road kind of thing, and it's actually not bad. Like, the views are incredible, and it's kind of a nice change from walking downhill constantly. Like, all of our feet and knees are aching, so just being on kind of a dirt road for a while feels pretty nice. And there's this like epic river valley here. We crossed 2 waterfalls so far, and we have a jacuzzi waiting for us back at our camp. Yeah. Close.
Touch strong, maybe. Yeah, that is.
Oh, there it goes.
It's moving, look at that.
Yeah.
Little by little.
Wow. Here, and we had to make a decision to like keep walking across, get your shoes wet, or take them off. So I took mine off, but I got dry shoes mostly, so that's good.
Está cerrada la tienda.
Reservado para mí.
No, él no tiene suficiente años para tomar. Hay que ver la cédula de él.
Benedito, ¿dónde ponemos? Ayúdame con los dafos, papá.
¿Le ayudo? Oh, oh, wow!
Marie, six, you're in your room. Okay.
Oh, welcome, welcome.
Is there a light?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, it's not working yet.
The other one, try the other one. Oh my god, so no oscuras. Bravo.
Go.
Huh. How is your room?
I like it. It's really nice.
Oh, nice.
No way, no way. I know they're burning. Oh.
Robert, you're getting the big one.
French cookies, no baby.
French cookies. I love how our doors are like set up for the view, you know?
I know.